Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. And today we are going to be looking at armor stands and animating armor stands. There's a few different ways to do this. We're going to be looking at this particular way using redstone repeaters, pressure plates, and so on. Let's turn around and dive straight in and have a quick look at the armor stands. Okay, so here are the armor stands. Now, you can craft these using sticks and a smooth stone slab on the crafting table. It's the only way to get them. All right, so you go to the crafting table, sticks, I think go like this. Smooth stone slab goes there. Yeah, where are those sticks? There we go. Armor stands. So, drag your armor stand down here. That's the only way to create it, but once you've got an armor stand, there's lots of things you can do with it. And we're not going to go into lots of depth on this video, but armor stands are kind of an unusual item, really. As you can see, they rotate based on your position when you place them down. So they don't always face in the same way. They're not always parallel to other blocks that are placed. If you shift click on them, you can change their position. Right, so just like in Bedrock Edition, you can throw these armor stands in here and animate them, and they do come with arms. I know in Java Edition, they don't have arms on them. You can put them on with a bit of code. And as you might have guessed, you can put armor on them. That's kind of what they're intended for, really. But there's so many things you can do with them because the coding treats them as entities. So you might wonder why I've got chickens and horses roaming around. That is if you turn off mobs. The armor stands don't work. They don't come up. Right, so you've got to have mobs turned on, or allowed, sorry, for this one to work. Now, what we're going to look at doing today is animating those armor stands and get them kind of grooving around a little bit. And the way we do that is we send a redstone signal to them. Now, armor stands are interesting in the idea that they will strike a different pose based on the strength of the redstone signal. So as you might be aware, a redstone signal outputs for a little while, and then it needs a repeater to keep it going. And the further it's outputted, the weaker the signal is. So let's take a look at how that works. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. It's getting weaker and weaker, and there you can see it runs out. So each one of these technically is a different stance, which is pretty cool, I think. Yeah, look at that. So the different redstone signal gives a different output. Now, that's fine. If we just turn that off, when we put a different redstone signal to them, they will give a different pose, but they all give a slightly different pose because they're all a different distance away from the source of redstone, which is the whole idea behind this concept. So let's get started. So all the redstone for these guys is tucked away underneath. Here you can see the redstone coming in, and the redstone goes to the block that the armor stand is on. So the armor stands are resting on a block around here, and the redstone's going to those blocks. And what we want to do, what we want to try and get our students to do, is to create a system whereby each armor stand is going to is receiving a different strength redstone signal every kind of second or so. Now, we are working in Minecraft Education, it's the whole point of this channel, so I thought let's go ahead and use the agent. We like the agent, and we can do a bit of coding while we're at it. So what happens is here is that we press the pressure plate, and it sends out a redstone signal that goes up here to the armor stand, but it also goes out to the other armor stands as well. These are all connected to the four different armor stands, but each pressure plate is a different distance away from each armor stand. So technically, every time the agent walks on a pressure plate, it's going to send a different strength redstone signal to each different armor stand every time, which is the plan. So let's have a little look at our coding. Let's make this full screen. So we can, that was our test one, so we can get rid of that. It works, we know it works. So on chat command, disco, we're going to get the agent to move forward and step on the first plate, and then he's going to repeat this 10 times. So he's going to move forward by three, pause. I actually just put these in case I want to change the timings afterwards. So he's going to move forward by three, wait, move forward by three, and then back and do the same. So let's see how that translates to what we've got here. Why are you there, agent? Let's move you back one. And let's move you back one again. There we go. That's where he should start. So he's going to move. He's going to start off moving forward one. Then he's going to move forward three, 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 back three, three, three. He's going to repeat that 10 times, and that should see the armor stands. Let's fly back up here. Whoa, hello. Okay, that should see the armor stands throw in some pretty cool shapes. Let's press. Let's type disco, and off they go. Look, they're looking pretty good there. With their various different poses. Yeah, nice. Okay, so how can we kind of extend this task a little bit for your students? Well, what I decided to do was build a little bit of a backdrop, a little bit of a stage. So here we have got some redstone lamps with some glowstones around the edge, and we've animated those redstone lamps. So each redstone lamp is getting a signal via this pressure plate over here. So if I just fill in this gap and stand on the pressure plate, it will start this sequence going. So the redstone signal travels down here. This isn't connected to the armor stands. This one, it goes round out here, hits those top ones, and it just keeps going round and round. Should just stay on that redstone signal. It also branches off at one point and goes to a little firework display. We've done a video on firework displays, if anyone's interested, but just quickly, each dispenser has a different amount of repeaters going into it, and here in the dispenser, we've got 54 of each different type of firework, and as if by magic, the sun is just starting to go down. So let's get this running. We'll get the fireworks going, and we'll get the display running there, and then we'll get the agent doing his disco thing. Right, here we go. There we go, there goes the disco. When the signal goes round, we should get some fireworks. There we go. And let's type disco and just get the whole thing going. Look at that, what a show. So there we go, let's get this looking good. Now, as usual, this world will be available in the description for free download if you want to see how this works. Take a look at it. We will get more into armor stands as we go on. There's loads of cool stuff you can do with the armor stands. But with this lesson, yeah, I think we want to get our students started off by just learning about those different strengths of redstone signals. And then over time, we can add in the details around the edge as extensions and look at incorporating those fireworks and so on. It's some pretty interesting redstone work going on behind. Oh, look, the moon's coming up there. Going on behind this backdrop here to get all those redstone lamps lighting up. So I'm sure your students will enjoy getting those all working and running. And like I say, the world is available for free if you want to take a look behind the scenes and see how it works. When you load up the world, make sure you allow mobs, otherwise the armor stands will not be there, which will be a bit annoying. So make sure that you do that, please. Also, make sure you like and subscribe. Leave a comment for the algorithm. trying to get to 1,000 subscribers before the end of the year. So if you could help me out with that, that would be awesome. But until next time, have a good one.